I would like to ask Andrew to remove his shirt so that, you know, everyone here could get an accurate idea of what we're talking about.
Objection, Your Honor. It would unfairly influence the jury.
Your Honor, if Andrew was forced to use a wheelchair due to his illness, would the defense ask him to park it outside because it would unfairly influence the jury? Come on, we're talking about AIDS. We're talking about lesions. Let's see what we're talking about.
I'll allow it. Mr. Beckett, would you please remove your shirt? My God, what a nightmare.
He asked for it.
Sometimes men take matters into their own hands.
No, sir. You made it clear just a moment ago that your men never take matters in their own hands. Your men follow orders or people die. So Santiago shouldn't have been in any danger at all, should he have, Colonel?
You snotty little bastard.
Your Honor, I'd like to ask for a recess.
I'd like an answer to the question, Judge.
The court will wait for an answer.
If Lieutenant Kendrick gave an order that Santiago wasn't to be touched, then why did he have to be transferred? Colonel? Lieutenant Kendrick ordered the code red, didn't he? Because that's what you told Lieutenant Kendrick to do.
Object!
And when it went bad, you cut these guys loose!
Your Honor, you had
Marcus
inside a phony transport!
Your Honor, you doctored the logbook!
Damn it, Captain!
You coerced the doctor!
Consider yourself in contempt!
Colonel Jessup, did you order the code red?
You don't have to answer that question.
I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled to.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
Very few German knew what was going on. Very few! None of us knew what was happening. The place is shown on these films. None of us! But the most ironic part of it is that the prosecution showed these films against these defendants. Men who stayed in power for one reason only, to prevent worse things from happening. Who is the braver man? The man who escapes or resigns in times of peril? Or the man who stays on his post at the risk of his own personal safety?
My client. You open your mouth, you're losing my case for me.
Now listen to me, Phil.
No, you listen to me. All I want on this trial was a fair shake. Okay? Push me into court 5 days early. I lose my star witness, and I can't get a continuance, and I don't care. I'm going up there, I'm gonna try it, I'm gonna let the jury decide. You know, they told me about you. Said you're a hard ass, you're a defendant's judge. Well, I don't care. I said to hell with it, to hell with it!
Look, Galvin, many years ago...
Come on. Hey, don't give me that shit about you being a lawyer, too. I know about you. You couldn't hack it as a lawyer. You were a bag man for the boys downtown, and you still are. I know about you.
Are you done?
You're damn right I'm done. I'm gonna ask for a mistrial. I'm gonna request that you disqualify yourself from sitting on this case. I'm gonna take a transcript of the trial to the Judicial Conduct Board and ask that they impeach your ass.
You aren't gonna get a mistrial, boy. We're going back there this afternoon, and we're going to try this case to the end. Now you get out of here before I call the bailiff and have you thrown in jail.
Mrs. Kramer, can you tell the court why you are asking for custody?
Because he's my child. And because I love him. I know I left my son. I know that that's a terrible thing to do. Believe me, I have to live with that every day of my life. But in order to leave him, I had to believe that it was the only thing I could do. And that it was the best thing for him. I was incapable of functioning in that home. And I didn't know what the alternative was going to be. So I thought it was not best that I take him with me. However, I've since gotten some help. And I have worked very, very hard to become a whole human being. And I don't think I should be punished for that. And I don't think my little boy should be punished. Billy's only 7 years old. He needs me. I'm not saying he doesn't need his father, but I really believe he needs me more.
Well, had you ever gone to the Thunder Bay Inn or elsewhere in Thunder Bay alone at night?
Yes, sometimes.
Did your husband know you were going?
Not always. He goes to sleep early, and sometimes I'm restless.
Where did you go on these occasions?
Oh, I'd take a walk by the lake or went to the bingo place. Maybe to the inn.
You ever go to meet another man?
No, I didn't. I never did that.
You mean to say, Mrs. Mannion, a lovely woman like yourself, attractive to men? Lonely, restless, that you never once...
Objection, Your Honor. Witness has answered the question about other men. Counsel's now making a veiled suggestion to the jury.
I withdraw the question. Now, Mrs. Mannion, on these occasional excursions into the night, did you always go and return home alone?
Of course.
But, Mrs. Mannion, you testified that the reason you got into Barney Quill's car was because you were afraid to go home alone. Why were you so frightened on this particular night?
I said that it was because he told me bears had been seen around.
Was this the first time you'd heard that bears came around Thunder Bay to pick up scraps?
No.
Do you know who this is, Mr. Dixon?
No, I don't.
Well, then, would you be so kind as to read the statement that you took from him on the 3rd of November, 1974? A statement, my lord, which vindicates all of these people, all these innocent people.
My lord, I need to see a copy of this statement.
Someone, either that man or his superior or his superior's superior, ordered that these people be used as scapegoats by a nation that was baying for blood.
My lord!
In return for the innocent blood spilled on the streets of Guildford. And by God, you've got your blood, Mr. Dixon.
Speech. This is outrageous.
You've got the blood of Giuseppe Conti, you've got the lifeblood of Carol Richardson, and you've got 15 years of blood and sweat and pain from my client, whose only crime was that he was bloody well Irish, and he was foolish, and he was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Mrs. Pierce, I will have you removed from the court.
Mrs. Rowe. Or Mrs. Helm, which do you prefer to be called?
It does not matter.
Does it not? In this country, we are inclined to take a rather more serious view of marriage. However, Frau Helm, it would appear, that when you first met the prisoner in Hamburg, you lied to him about your marital status?
I wanted to get out of Germany, so...
You lied, did you not? Just yes or no, please.
Yes.
Thank you. And subsequently, in arranging the marriage, you lied to the authorities?
I did not tell the truth to the authorities.
You lied to them?
Yes.
And in the ceremony of marriage itself, when you swore to love and to honor and to cherish your husband, that too was a lie?
Yes.
And when the police questioned you about this wretched man who believes himself married and loved, you told them?
I told them what Leonard wanted me to say.
You told them that he was at home with you at 25 minutes past 9, and now you say that that was a lie?
Yes, a lie.
And when you said that he had accidentally cut his wrist, again you lied.
Yes.
And now today you've told us a new story entirely. The question is, Frau Helm, were you lying then? Are you lying now? Or are you not, in fact, a chronic and habitual liar?
Is this the man who raped you?
Well, certainly is.
How?
I don't know how. He done it. He just done it.
You have testified that he choked you and he beat you. You didn't say that he sneaked up behind you and knocked you out cold, but that you turned around and there he was. Do you want to tell us what really happened?
Guilty. 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 Not guilty. Guilty.
Boy, how do you like that?
Oh, another chap flips his wings.
All right. Who was it? Come on, I want to know.
Excuse me, this was a secret ballot. We all agreed on that, no? If the gentleman wanted to remain secret...
Secret? What do you mean, secret? There are no secrets in a jury room. I know who it was.
Brother, you really are something. You sit here, vote guilty like the rest of us, then some golden voice preacher starts tearing your poor heart out about some underprivileged kid just couldn't help becoming a murderer, and you change your vote. If that isn't the most sickening... Why don't you drop a quarter in this collection box?
Oh, now, just wait a minute. Listen, you can't talk to me like that. No, who do you think you are?
Calm down, calm down.
No, what does he think he is?
It doesn't matter. He's very excitable. Sit down.
Excitable? You bet I'm excitable. We're trying to put a guilty man in the chair where he belongs. Someone stops telling us fairy tales and we're listening.